A classical Chinese landscape is not meant to reproduce an actual view, as would a Western figurative painting. Now, Chinese landscape does not reproduce an actual view of anything, does not depict any actual view. It generally is about some philosophy, some theory, some concept, some idea which is there in the painter's mind. So he wants the spectator to understand the concept behind it. While a Western painter does figurative painting, that means his paintings are based on real objects. It is a form of art that retains strong references to the real world as the painter's subject matter. That means objects of the real world would be his subject matter. That means art work derived from real object sources. So it is in contrast to the Chinese landscape, which is based on abstract idea. Whereas the European painter wants you to borrow his eyes and look at a particular landscape exactly as he saw it from a specific angle, the Chinese painter does not choose a single viewpoint. Now, European painter would want the spectator to borrow his eyes. Borrowing his eyes means to look at the painting the way he wants you to, the way he wants the spectator to look at it, from a particular angle, to look at from a specific angle. While the Chinese painter would allow the spectator to start looking at the painting from anywhere, just let him travel his eyes and find out what was this abstract idea behind that painting. What was there in the painter's mind? That is all about Chinese painting. So that is a difference. European painting is more depending on the lines and shapes and perspective, colors, quality and different dimensions. While Chinese painter, the painting is all about abstract idea. They will have some concept, some philosophy behind it. His landscape is not a real one, not based on real objects. And you can enter it from any point. You don't have to look at it from any certain angle, like in European painting. You can enter, that means the spectator can enter in the sense, look at the painting from anywhere, from any point. And he has to actually take time to understand the concept, the abstract idea of the painter. Then travel in it. The artist creates a path for your eyes to travel up and down, then back again in a leisurely movement. So in Chinese painting, the artist creates a path for your eyes to travel up and down. That means you have to take time to you have to give, the spectator has to give lot of time to understand the painting. To understand his painting, to understand the work, his eyes would travel everywhere. There is no specific starting point. Then he can travel back and forth, up and down. And then he would understand the imagination of the painter. This is even more true in the case of the horizontal scroll. Now, traditional Chinese painting is also very famous in the form of horizontal scroll. So in which the action of slowly opening one section of the painting, so it is like coming the painting, the whole painting comes in sequence. So it is like slowly opening one section of the painting, then rolling it up to move on to the other, then rolling it, and adds a dimension of time. So that means one section at a time. First the spectator will understand one section, then again the next section will come before his eyes, then he will again travel, he'll keep traveling, his eyes and mind will keep traveling. So there would be a dimension of time in horizontal scroll. That is also a kind of Chinese painting, which is unknown in any other form of painting. Dimension of time is not very popular in any other form of painting. In horizontal scroll, dimension of time is also added. That means the spectator looks at the painting, understands the painting in sections, and he goes in sequence one at a time. It also requires the active participation of the viewer, who decides at what pace he will travel through the painting. It depends on the viewer at what pace means speed, he would travel through the painting. A participation which is physical as well as mental. Physical because he is looking at it with his eyes, as well as mental, his imagination will also start working. The Chinese painter does not want you to borrow his eyes. He wants you to enter his mind. He wants you to understand what the painter had imagined, his imagination. So one has to enter the painter's mind to understand his piece of work. The landscape is an inner one, a spiritual and conceptual space. So such landscape is an inner one, spiritual. Spiritual, it is a spiritual journey and conceptual space. Now conceptual space is a term which is used for an idea to be depicted in the painting. Concept is generally an abstract idea representing the fundamental characteristics of what it represents. So conceptual space is about working on the concept by the representation of a number of quality dimensions of any object. For example, its color, size, etc.